It sounds good together. Come welcome, bro. Wait, hey, that's so you coffee latte, yeah?
Double. The barista said this is the best syrup.
I'm just doing a passion today, man. How you been, bro?
I'm easy.
Last time I was on your show, today you're on my show. So you actually do quite a lot of stuff, man.
Cheers, my bro.
Cheers. Juice and coffee, man.
Juice and coffee.
Energy. You're saying coffee is your that's your drink, right?
Let me tell you, with coffee I'm good because I have a very long day. Normally I have very long days, very early or very late.
Yeah.
So the only way I can keep my energy levels up as a creative is with coffee.
What's your diet looking like? You're a very healthy guy. You got your muscles over there. You got your guns.
Let me tell you, okay. I don't have any special diet that I use. Mm-hmm. I just eat what I find.
You eat what you find.
I eat what I find, or I eat what I want.
And it keeps you running on stage. Good, I see you're the real hype man, bro.
Yeah, man.
Once you're on stage, you're up there. You even interact with the crowd. Yeah. Even when we did our show together, there was a lot of energy consumed via that show when we were over there at, whatchamacallit, right? Yeah.
Let me tell you, Switch TV, man, it's crazy.
Switch, big up Switch.
And I think for me, it's just a God-given gift.
Yeah.
It's just God-given 100%.
You've always known you wanted to do this?
No. When I was young, my mom tells me, I used to say, when there were these holidays, like Madaraka Day, Kenyatta Day, I'd march in the sitting room, I'd tell her, I'm taka kuwa polisi wa moja. I was a scout, and that was really cool. I loved the uniform, I loved the medals, and that general look.
The badges and everything,
and I'm like, Later on, I realized that my mom was a banker. You know, when you get a bit older, you're like, mom, what do you do? I'm working a bank, sticking to the bank. It looks really cool in the bank, This is where the money is,
That's
so I wanted to be a banker. In high school, I thought about being a pilot. I remember when I was trying to do, my form four, when you're trying to select, your college application. I wanted to do law. I finished form four, I realized, I directed the lawyer a little bit and I realized this is not what I wanted to do.
Yeah.
So I was very confused, man. And then I got saved and I wanted to do, to do God's work, do good things. So I tried theology. I went to this theology school and I'm like, I don't agree with your doctrine.
You don't agree with
this
it?
This is bad teaching, man. This is not in the Bible, man. Bomboclad.
Bomba.
This biblical teaching.
Leave it out.
They are cheating, man.
Come on.
They used to tell you, you come in the morning and wash the place like servants. And I'm like, why? Because it's the Lord's work.
Wait, is it to come and wash the place?
Yeah, man. And I'm a student paying fees. I'm like, this is a messed up joint. I won't even talk bad about it. I'm like doing that, but I'm like, no, man, this ain't for me.
Yeah.
Then after that, I tried French. I went to Alliance.
Wait, so you know a bit of French?
Dude, bonjour, basic.
Come on.
Hey, bonjour.
Bonjour, je m'appelle.
Je m'appelle David.
Trap King. That's as far as I go with my friends,
so
bro.
I know very basic.
Yeah.
But I was like, yo, this class is in the afternoon. Afternoon, do kuna form as it, kuna mamishoni nini. Hi, this session na uwezi.
Man.
So I dropped out of that. I was like, what am I gonna do? Then I went to University of Nairobi. I told my mom, listen, mom, now I know what I want to do. Right now, I don't know which degree I want to do, but I know that business is very important.
Mm.
And whichever line I'll end up in, being a businessman is going to help me later.
Yeah.
So I convinced her. And she paid for me the fee at University of Nairobi. I did a diploma in business management. And at the same time, I'm still doing my music, by the way, because I did my music immediately after form four. So I'm trying to balance between music and school. And my mom is like, nah, masomo.
Focus.
Masomo. Soma. Lazima. Okay.
You better finish that.
Yeah, I gotta finish that. So she was like, that ear in my voice in my ear, like, you gotta go to school, man. You gotta go to school. You gotta go to school. When are you getting a degree? You gotta go to school.
So but that voice is good sometimes.
Yeah.
It just remind, I don't want the nagging.
A rebel, bro. You
know? I'm telling
so,
you.
So, yeah, so I did my diploma.
Mm.
I realized business is a good field for me. And then I went to USIU. I did my undergraduate, 4 years. I finished, continued hustling. And then I did my global executive MBA. Really an amazing program. Yeah, man.
You're not just a musician. You're not just a hype man. A businessman comes into it, yeah, where you can even say entrepreneur. Like, you're doing a lot of things. Like, it's not just entertainment. You can take it away from entertainment.
Yeah.
I know you're doing this Panguza.
Panguza, yes.
You're promoting Panguza right now. Yeah. I was reading up about it. It was about like a teenage pregnancy,
exactly,
right?
Exactly.
And I saw one of the most extreme cases I saw was last year's statistics in Mombasa, 8,000.
Kilifi. Yes.
I was in Kilifi last year.
Were you a contributor?
No. I wasn't looking to the camera. I came with my own. I came with my own lady. Like, but like, I can imagine in those kind of festival settings or surroundings.
Let me tell you the scenario. So the statistics are really shocking.
Mm-hmm.
And everyone was talking about this during KCSE last year, saying, oh my God, we can't have this number of students giving back in. During KCSE, someone is giving birth, they're sitting the papers in maternity wards.
Man.
Some, you know, cannot sit the paper at all. 40,000 reported cases, that means those are the ones that are documented. So how many more ended up in illegal abortions?
Yeah, true.
You know what I'm saying? How many more end up unreported?
And it's not safe as well.
Exactly. It's unsafe. And then you realize that young people are having sex, okay? We cannot stop them from having sex. That's point number one, and I think that needs to be very clear. Because they're having sex for different reasons. Reason number one, young people are having sex because it's fun.
Yeah.
Sex is fun. Sex was good, homie.
About that, man.
Like, let's be real. And for a long time, you know, the society has been pretending that this is not happening. Our young people are very nice. Even you tell a father, his daughter is pregnant, and he's like, that cannot be my girl.
How can this happen?
And, you know, I'm a parent as well. And I'm like, you don't want to think about your daughter like that. You know what I'm saying? Like, you are naive, or you create a sort of like
a barrier
in your mind. Like, this little girl cannot do this.
Yeah, exactly.
She doesn't like boys. Boys are bad.
But it's happening.
But it's happening, and we need to do something because it's happening irresponsibly.
True.
Then there's like the cliff issue. It's a little bit is a transactional sex. This teenagers having sex with the tourists, also the locals. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? Because there's no money.
True.
So sex has become currency. That if you want to eat dinner, lunch, or breakfast, you sleep with this guy, Mzungu, or Kenyan, or whatever,
and then you're gonna
and
get
he gives you X amount of money, and you're good, you're sorted. You can take that money home, you can pay for unga, you can pay for steamer, paraffin, whatever the issue is at home, you sort that. So even the parents are aware that this is happening, and I was reading that report by UNICEF, and they're like, parents are aware, but they are unwilling to help their kids get out of it because there's no food at home.
There's no food out. So they're okay with their daughter going and doing whatnot, etc.
Hard man's world, bro.
Man. So how do you feel the way forward is? Like,
the way forward is for us to pull our weight and address the issue head on because it's a crisis. So what Punguza is a youth empowerment initiative that is focused on sensitization and advocacy, and we are encouraging young people to reduce irresponsible sexual behavior. So we know that sex is happening for whatever reason, but it's not going to stop. So what do? We encourage young people, if they must engage in sexual relationships, that they do it responsibly. You don't have to have a baby because you had sex. You can use a condom. You don't have to get HIV/AIDS infection because 33% of the new HIV/AIDS infections are amongst youth.
Wow.
That's a problem.
That is a big problem, especially if it's 33% amongst youth.
Amongst youth. So you tell me, so the only way to do it is to address it, to talk about it, and to encourage them, you know, to go for counseling, to go for family planning services, get your IUDs, get your condoms, man.
Yeah.
Get your pills. You don't have to be a 13-year-old who had sex because you're having a good time with your boyfriend and now you're dropping out of school.
Exactly.
Come on.
Conversations, I think, you know, because like I feel like in Kenya or not just Kenya but Africa, right? Like the conversations about sex with parents and children is so taboo. So I feel like if you're ignoring it and you don't want to talk to your son or you don't want to talk to your daughter about it, and then one day your daughter comes back to the house and says, "Daddy, I'm pregnant."
Yeah, knocked up some chick, man. And the dad is coming for me. Let's go. Shotgun.
Shotgun, boy. Shotgun. Keep that one ready. But like, I think the prevention is better than the solution.
And that's what I'm saying. So we need to educate young people, because you find that, you know, when you do our research, a lot of people perhaps don't know that these solutions exist, mm-hmm. that you can use protection or that you can use contraceptives. Also, something else is that there's the shyness and the stigma. Mm. You find that a young guy cannot walk into a chemist and ask for Nipe Trust, boss. I'm a Nipe Durex, I'm a ile raha.
I do that with confidence. I'm not even gonna lie.
But you see, you're a mature guy, so you've done it over years.
But yeah,
how was
exactly.
it your first time? Let's go to you, Krom. When did you first have sex?
If I'm gonna be
honest.
Honestly, I was around 12 years old the first time I ever had
sex. I was
13. So we both started when we were real young.
Did you know about condoms?
I didn't really. Nah, man. Like, the only way. Exactly, because I couldn't. For me,
dude.
I thought I was too young to go and ask in a chemist for Durex or anything.
You're going to tell your dad or your mom.
Exactly, and I did not want that embarrassment. And then on top of it as well, like, you know, like my brothers, I used to go into their wallets or into their jeans. And sometimes I pick. But they had some really old condoms. Right?
Yeah, and that one, you know, if
you know
press
who you
it
are.
And it doesn't have pressure, that one is not good to go.
At holes, man.
That one is a like, poop scabby.
I'm telling you, I've seen some very old. There was a time I used a condom which had been for over a year, like a year old.
What was the result, my brother?
It doesn't work 99% when it's after a year, I'll tell you that right now.
So are you parenting?
Not that I know of.
No.
Not that I know of. And I hope like they would tell me. I hope someone would tell me.
Sometimes these chicks don't want to get babies, so they remove their baby.
Yeah.
You know how easy it is to get an abortion in this country?
Man.
You can get an abortion in CBD.
You just go straight to town?
Yeah.
One time.
CBD. The last I checked, it was about 5K.
5K?
Yeah, that's how much it is.
That's easy. That's hella easy.
So now they're like really good ones, they're the middle level ones, and they're the, you know, gangster.
5K.
Shauriako.
But that's dangerous, man.
It's dangerous, bro.
That's dangerous.
You see, if you're a teenager, or you're in first year, second year university, you don't have a job, you don't want to tell your dad or your mom, but you're pregnant or you got a chick pregnant. So what's the solution, bro? Niku changa changa mazeni okole niko niko kwanoma niko kongori mazeni toleri yeng niende ni.
Get it done. CBD.
So that's what's happening in this country. And people are pretending that it's not happening.
Yeah.
We need to say enough is enough. Itabidi tupunguze na tuchanuke. Ndio tuweze sasa kupata solutions ama. Like if we remove the stigma, for example, and you've decided, man, I'm gonna have sex. No one can stop you. Even if your parent gives you coffee, you can have sex in the morning.
One time.
You know what I mean? Like parents think, yo, I give my daughter a coffee of 7 p.m. She's not going to misbehave.
I'll wake up at 6.
At 6. I'm going to school on my way, I divert.
One time.
That's what's happening. So, if we remove the stigma
and
say a young person can go to a chemist or whatever health facility and get themselves contraceptive, right, to prevent these pregnancies, haven't we solved the problem?
True.
We need to remove that
We're
stigma, you know, in the parents, the churches, the peers themselves, even those, the pharmacists, the chemists, they need to know, man, like,
exactly.
Don't start asking me questions.
But even in churches,
when
like
I'm coming to buy a condom, bana, ati unaenda kufanyia nini,
naenda
kufanyia nini,
of course, why am I buying it for?
Naenda kucheza baruti, I'm a blada.
By the way, to do what? Making balloons,
you know those questions, like, you feel like, don't say kibari.
Yeah, true. No, true. It's off-putting, you're like, why am I going to go back to this place again?
So
and you won't.
Mi kama mtu mzima ukiniuliza hivyo na kutukana. Lakini, ukiwa 13, unarudi inje. Unatoroka, sindio?
True.
So, dry fry bamba. And STDs. STDs.
And that's the next problem.
STDs, CNN Health, man, documented this year, a million STDs being documented per day. You know what that means? That people are really sick.
Man, very sick.
People are carrying venereal diseases,
very
my brother.
Sick. So yes, my name is Chat King Krom, and we're still live with the one and only DNG.
Yeah,
I'm just man.
Behind the scenes.
Entrepreneur. This guy does everything. Is the Punguza project your only project that you're pushing this year?
No, not really. We are all about youth at 254 Entertainment, and we made it a conscious decision to engage in social impact activities.
Nice.
But our focus is youth. So apart from Pumuza, which is the second youth initiative we are unveiling, we initially started off with another one called Hustle Yako in 2017.
Okay, yeah, I know Hustle Yako.
So we're still pushing that. So Hustle Yako, we started off 2017. We did amazing stuff. We did the launches internally with corporate sponsors at the time, Oriflame. We did our first youth event at CTEC University. Then we got very strategic partnerships with 1FM. So we had a 1 hour show every weekday, Monday to Friday.
Yeah. I remember that. Come on, bro.
The only station. Giving economic empowerment opportunities to young people. So that's what we were doing. And we bring in successful entrepreneurs, career professionals, business people, you know, anybody.
Pushing the future.
Yeah, from different sectors of the economy, agribusiness, politics, communication, music, art. So we did that. Then we did the live and concert Spin Masters, where we gave DJs who are upcoming an opportunity to shine.
Upcoming DJs, they come through, whatnot, they can win a prize. Showcase, live.
Sell themselves for 1 hour every Friday. When I was growing up, single mom family, and my mom,
big up all the mothers out there.
Yeah, my mom was a real hustler, bro. Real hustler. I never lacked. And I remember going for shopping. And we used to shop in a place called Freemark.
Freemark
was in near Railways Club, you know. And it was burnt down, man, by haters.
Why?
I'm just saying, man, like, we were crazy in this city.
Man.
But yo, we used to go there. It's like Nairobi stores.
Yeah.
It's the current Nairobi stores.
But that was the spot to go to.
Spot to go shop, bro. If you're not shopping for Freemark, it's either Freemark or Gikosh.
Okay.
Or Toy. Those are like the three main, or Kenyatta Market. Or now City Market also have very good shoes. Eh? So depending on where you are and how much you want to spend, those are the options. But Freemark were like new shoes, eh? not in Tumba.
Freemark.
Yeah. So my mom, you know, buys me these shoes, man. Air Max. Remember Air Max?
Yeah, I remember Air Maxes.
Air Max, man. But Air Max got two ticks. Mm-hmm. So it's got like a tick and another tick.
Yeah.
I'm like, this is a W.
Air Max.
So I'm like, mom, these are not original. Do you know what she told me? Work hard on when you make your own money, you go and buy your own original shoes. You ungrateful.
I like that.
You know what I'm saying? So my mom was always for, if I can't afford, I can't afford.
Exactly.
Too bad for you. And that hard training.
I like that lesson though.
For me, everything, my mom told me one day you will buy your own. I want a car, give me your car. No.
Man.
But my own car. Yeah, she tell me, yo, this is not your house. Get out of my house. Go my own house.
Come on.
You know what I'm saying?
Come on.
I'm like, she's like, buy your own shoes. I'm rocking my own J's. Yeah. So I just want to thank my mom.
Original as well.
For that hardcore training, because me was a very strong woman.
Yeah, hard headed guy.
I didn't get that military strength.
No, but for real, and I think.
I'm going to say,
I think that's a point, you know, we big up to all the mothers, just as DNGs, just as my mother as well, who are able to strike knowledge or whatnot, or however you want to call it, into a stubborn head's kid.
Yeah.
Into a stubborn kid's head.
Yeah.
I was stubborn as a child. I would always want the latest, whatnot, etc., whatnot, rah. It takes that person to say no.
Yeah.
For you to say why no?
And question your voice.
Exactly.
And also find your voice and then identity and what you believe in and your values.
I wish you had so much more time, but I know it's a very busy day. You got so much to do. Thank you so much for coming onto the GTP show. Man, it's crazy. We were talking about you last year. Now we have you on the show, man.
Yeah.
Absolutely amazing. Thank you, DNG, for coming through, man.
It's a pleasure, man.
Thank you, bro. Yes. Rah. Make sure you stay tuned into the GTP show. This is the Chat King Podcast. Brands.